Welcome students, welcome to my next video, chapter number 4, Colonialism and Marathas. मेरे प्रिय विद्यार्थियों, आपको मेरे वीडियो में स्वागत है. मैं कॉलोनियलिज्म और मराठा ये पार्ट मैं आज मेरे वीडियो में प्रस्तुत करना चाहता हूं. हम लोग देखेंगे कि शिवाजी महाराज उन्होंने फिरंगियों के साथ किस तरह का बर्ताव किया. उन्होंने फिरंगियों को भारत में प्रवेश जरूर दिया, लेकिन शिवाजी महाराज के व्यवहार उन फिरंगियों के साथ कैसा था, ये हम लोग इस पार्ट में देखेंगे. आए हम देखें, शिवाजी महाराज जो था वो भारत के गिने चुने राजाओं में है जो जाने माने माने जाते हैं. शिवाजी महाराज था, उन्होंने देखा कि फिरंगी लोग आ रहे हैं, पोर्चुगीज, अंग्रेज, डच, वो अपना धंधा बढ़ा रहे हैं यहाँ पे. तो वो अपना धंधा बढ़ा रहे हैं, उन्होंने उनको धंधा बढ़ाने दिया और उन पर कड़ी नजरें रखे. अगर उन्हें भारतवर्ष में अगर उन्हें धंधा करना ही था, बिजनेस करना ही था, तो उन्हें कर भरना पड़ता था. सिर्फ वही नहीं, शिवाजी महाराज जी जो थे उन्हें अपने मातृभूमि का भी रक्षण करना था. तो उन्होंने नेवी का गठन किया. ही मेड अ स्ट्रॉन्ग नेवी फोर्स एंड ही कंस्ट्रक्टेड सी फोर्ट्स. ही लेवर्ड ऑक्ट्रॉय ड्यूटी ऑन द कमोडिटीज विच वर सोल्ड इन इंडिया. जैसे अच्छा एक उदाहरण है कि अंग्रेज लोग अपना नमक भारत में बेचना चाहते थे, तो उस नमक पर इन्होंने कर लगाया शिवाजी महाराज ने. उसका मूल कारण क्या था, क्यों उन्होंने ये कर लगाया? कर लगाने का एक साधारण लॉजिक था कि जो बाहर से आने वाला नमक है उस पर कर लगने से वो महंगा हो जाता है और हमारे भारत में बना हुआ नमक सस्ता हो जाता है. इसके लिए वो हमारे भारत में बना हुआ नमक को, वो नमक वो जो बेचने वाले हैं उन्हें बचाने के लिए उन्होंने क्या किया, उन्होंने अंग्रेजों के नमक पर कर लगाया. सिर्फ वही नहीं, शंभाजी महाराज, जिस तरह शिवाजी महाराज इन फिरंगियों के साथ लड़ाई की, उसी तरह शंभाजी महाराज ने भी खूब लड़ाई की पोर्चुगीज के साथ. चिमाजी अप्पा जो बाजीराव के भाई थे, उन्होंने पोर्चुगीज को वसई में हरा दिया। और इस तरह मराठा जो था अपना दबदबा बनाए रखा और यूरोपियन लोगों को उन्हें एंट्री नहीं दिया। नाउ वी विल सी कॉलोनियलिज्म वर्सेस मराठा एम्पायर। पोर्चुगीज, फ्रेंच, डच, ब्रिटिश, दे ऑल केम टू इंडिया विद द इंटेंशन ऑफ ट्रेड्स। दे वर ट्रेडर्स, हाउएवर दे डिड नॉट स्टॉप एट दिस। दे स्टार्टेड ग्रैबिंग पॉलिटिकल पावर। It is often seen when India with weighing scale but used a sword and ultimately seized the Indian throne. The Portuguese were first to arrive in India. They were mentioned as Firangis. Not only that, all the historical documents of that period, they referred all the Europeans as Firangis. Now we'll see Portuguese and the Maratha Empire. Portuguese had their fort in Diu Daman, Sajan, Vasai, Karanja, Chol. Because of these forts, the region of Bardesh was well protected. They used to store all ammunition at Panvel. Shivaji Maharaj first came in contact with the Portuguese. He established his control over Kalyan and Bhiwandi. Portuguese were alarmed with Shivaji Maharaj because he has built a strong Maratha navy. Soon the Portuguese were brought to the point of despair by the Marathas. In fact, in the beginning, the Portuguese extended technological help for shipbuilding to Marathas. However, the Portuguese governor of Goa withdrew the help. The Portuguese now promptly provided help to Siddhis when the Marathas army was organizing an attack on Janjira fort against them. But the Portuguese and the Marathas, in the matter of diplomatic relation, adopted policy to suit the situation. In 1665, Portuguese waylaid 13 ships of Marathas while it was passing by the port on the Karnataka coast. However, they soon were released those ships as they were scared of the powerful Maratha navy. In 1666, while the fort of Fonda ruled by Adil Shah was under the siege by Marathas and the Portuguese supplied ammunition to Adil Shah Kiledar, on the other hand, they let Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj cross through their territory when he was returning after the sack of Surat. When Mirza Raje Jai Singh attacked Swarajya, the Portuguese extended support to the Marathas. The Portuguese established their factories at Dabol by obtaining sanction from Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. At the same time, the local people were unhappy because of Portuguese law, which were favorable for religious conversions. Therefore, in 1667, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj decided to attack Bardesh. People of Bardesh welcomed Shivaji Maharaj wholeheartedly again when in the region of Dandarajpuri, under Siddhi rule, was under Maratha siege. The Portuguese supplied the war to arms and munitions to Siddhis. During this Adil Shahi Sultanate versus Maratha conflict, the Portuguese, while actually acting neutral and helping Adil Shah. Now, my dear students, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, ही अग्रीड टू अवॉइड एनी फ्यूचर कॉन्फ्लिक्ट विद द पोर्चुगीज. छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज एंड इंटेंशन ऑफ अपरूटिंग पोर्चुगीज रूल स्टार्टेड सेंडिंग स्मॉल ग्रुप्स ऑफ हिज मेन टू गोवा. इट वॉज डिसाइडेड दैट वंस द नंबर वॉज इनफ इन गोवा दे शुड स्ट्राइक एंड रिवोल्ट अगेंस्ट पोर्चुगीज रूल. द पोर्चुगीज वाइस रॉय समहाउ बिकेम अवेयर ऑफ द प्लान. Hence, the plan failed. The treaty was signed between Portuguese and the Marathas on 10th February 1670. The following conditions were agreed upon. If either of them plundered the other ships, then the victim party should be properly compensated all the concessions given to the Mughal ships in transit should also be given to the Maratha ships. And also extended to Siddhis against Marathas, and not to build forts in the territory of Ramnagar, presently in the village of Johar, Tehsil Thane. There are disputes about issues of collecting Chauthai between Portuguese and the Marathas, which remain unresolved till the end. To resolve this issue, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj appointed Pitambar Shivani and Jivaji as a mediator. However, they were not much successful in negotiation. In 1679, Portuguese secretly helped the British in the conflict with the Marathas. Now, Shivaji Maharaj, he was determined to humble the Portuguese. There were many reasons for it, such as Portuguese opposing the construction work by the Marathas in Chaul, forcing their subjects in Goa for religious conversion, and pillaging of trading ships. The Marathas defeated Portuguese during the siege of Fonda Fort. The Maratha army gathered Fonda in 1680. Shivaji Maharaj himself led the campaign, but for some reason it could not happen. The panic by the Portuguese because of warfare skill of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, it was clearly reflected, and the Portuguese governor said Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj was no doubt mighty warrior, but his strategies against the enemy during the peaceful time was much more daunting. Now his death has revealed the Portuguese authority from his terror. Portuguese were alliance with Aurangzeb and the Mughal emperor against Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Therefore, Maratha decided to act against Portuguese. Hence, Chhatrapati Shambhaji Maharaj attacked Revadanda. The Portuguese reacted by putting Fonda Fort under siege. The Maratha army successfully broke through the siege and attacked Goa. Yesaji Kanke, the chief of the Maratha infantry, was very close associate of Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, fought with great valor. The Portuguese governor was injured on the battlefield. He had to beat a retreat. Chhatrapati Shambhaji Maharaj chased the Portuguese army, which got trapped in deadlock. However, the news that Mughal attack on the South Konkan received in the Maratha camp, Chhatrapati Shambhaji Maharaj and his army, who were on the verge of conquering Goa, had to leave halfway to rush to fight against the Mughals. Later, the conflict between Marathas and Portuguese renewed during the reign of Chhatrapati Shahu Maharaj. A treaty was signed between Marathas and Hussain Ali Sayyid, the chief or representative of Mughals in the south, which gave a right of collecting Chauthai to the Mughals and the Kalyan Bhiwandi region. Accordingly, they have asked Portuguese to make payment. However, the Portuguese governor of Vasai refused to pay. The center of Marathas and the Portuguese established outposts in Vasai, Tarapur, Kelwe, Mahim, Daman and Chaul. They also increased the intensity and atrocities on the local people. Chimaji Appar, the younger brother of Peshwa Bajirao, was assigned responsibility of campaign against Portuguese. At the onset of the campaign, Chimaji Appa took over the fort at Thane in 1737, March 1737. The Maratha army conquered Shasti Island. On the other hand, Shankarji Phadke entered Vasai Island. However, taking Vasai was not enough to establish permanent control over Portuguese territory. There was a complete victory over the fort of Vasai. The Marathas fought valiantly, but their naval force was not strong enough. The Maratha siege of the Vasai fort continued for 2 years, and in the end, the Marathas defeated the Portuguese. Now, thank you very much, my dear students, for your patient hearing. I would like to end this first part. It's a sincere request, children. Students, if you like the video, please do like it. If you have not subscribed it, please subscribe it. And if others are not aware of this video, please give the awareness and ask them to subscribe the channel. Thank you. And I wish you all the best for your examination.